Hello, Capricorn. Rosie wanted to say hello. She wants to be right on top of me this morning. It's a cold and rainy day in Chicago, and I'm going to tuck her right back there, and we're going to jump into your reading. So I hope everyone's doing well. Let's take a look and see what the overall messages are for Capricorn in love for the week of July 1st through the 7th. This is a you versus them reading. Let's see what we have. What do we have here for the messages? There we go. Okay. Ooh, chaos and conflict. First card out. We have remain flexible. And we have Treasure Island. So this is definitely a relationship that requires some flexibility. The two of you look like you're going through a hot period of time. We have a lot of very, very tough astrological energy. So let's look, Capricorn, and see what your feelings are, followed by your person's feelings. Let's see, how do you see your person in the recent past? What's your energy? Ooh, Three of Wands, this could be the one. Your energy currently is a death card. Ooh, chaos and conflict. You could be on the verge of ending the relationship, or there's something that has to transform, right? Death and rebirth. How you see the situation as you go forward, the Ten of Coins. So one thing that I'm seeing is that you want marriage, you want the whole package. That's very much Virgo energy, Scorpio energy, and Aries energy. And you really want the whole plan. I mean, you want a legacy marriage. Okay, how you view the other person, you view them as a person who's not paying a lot of attention to you. The Ace of Coins, how you feel in your heart space. You would really like something significant with this person. You'd like an offer or a new beginning. How you view the situation, you see it as like wish fulfillment. This is Aquarius energy. You see this person in many ways as very ideal. Okay, you see them as a rock star. They could be famous, they may not be, but it does look as though you hold this person in very high self-esteem, or a high esteem, not self-esteem, a high esteem, and you would really like to have your wish fulfilled in a romance with them, up to and including marriage. Hidden right now is you searching for answers. You are on the lookout for hints or clues or whatever's going on with them. The Temperance card says that for those of you who've had an argument, and I feel as though you did with the chaos and conflict and the death card, I definitely feel as though there was probably a hotly contested topic, shall we say. And you're coming in with this beautiful Sagittarius energy. You're like, you know what? We can work anything out. It's not a problem. And it's not a problem in terms of how you feel. Okay, Seven of Cups is the outcome for the week. It's only a week. And it really says that right now, you really don't know what you don't know. And, you know, you're willing to keep your options open, and, you know, you're willing to go out with other people because you simply don't know what's going on with your person. All right, let's see their energy here in the recent past. Let's see what it was. I will give you the table shot at the point that we clarify the cards. Okay, so your person's feeling a little defensive. They feel as though you're challenging them in some way. What's the death card here? Why is it here? That was a recent past. They felt challenged. Why is the death card here? Oh, no, excuse me. What does your person feel about this? Because you're very much, if this person's not interested in marriage and long-term commitment, you're just out. You're tapping out. The Fool card. So your person is really looking at this, and they're looking at the fact that they are open to a new beginning with you. You know, your person is very much the Fool card. You know, take the leap of faith. You know, it's the next step. It's a card of manifestation coming in the near future. So while you are viewing your person as bored, they're viewing you as being very romantic. Knight of Cups energy. They don't necessarily think that you want what they want, but Knight of Cups energy says that they do think that you might be more of a lightweight. They're seeing you as someone who wants what you want, but you're not really tethered to them in any way. The Justice card is telling me that while you would like a substantial offer, they want balance in the relationship. So the Justice card can also indicate, it is actually the marriage card, and it does indicate that they would like a balanced, happy relationship, but only if it's going to be happy. And they also might want a prenuptial agreement. So we get this energy. It's quite lovely. I like it. Okay, so let's see what they felt about their view forward. Their view forward is also the Two of Cups, and that is clarifying. That's next to your Ten of Pentacles. So you are on the same page with your person. The difference is it looks like you've caused a little bit of a ruckus by stating your needs. Like, well, if you aren't interested in marriage, then I'm out. You tapped out. And here we go, Capricorn Queen. So the Capricorn Queen is how they view you, Capricorn. They see you. You see them as a rock star, and they see you as a person. Oh, my gosh. And they see you as a person that is very much, who you are. They see you in a very, very clear-cut way. They see you as a person who's very serious and very stable and very loving, very giving. So where you're searching for answers, they're looking for a victory. I don't always like this card. A victory can be a notch in the belt, so we're going to check that out. Okay, where you want temperance, you want a very level, balanced form of communication. They might have strong Libra energy because we have the Justice card and now Judge Judy, which means that your person cuts anything out of their lives that does not serve them. They're quick to make judgment. So the outcome card for you is the Seven of Cups. For them, it's the Eight of Swords. Not really any action taking place. It looks like they leave for a time to heal. It does look like this was an argument. For many of you, it looks like something has really happened, a falling out of some sort. But you're both very much on the same page in terms of long-term goals. So now we're going to go ahead and take a look and see what we have for why. Let's clarify this Three of Wands. Why is the Three of Wands here? So you really do see this person as a potential. I'm not taking all those. You do see this person as your potential future person, okay? Okay, so let's see what's going to clarify that card. Let's see what we have here. Wheel of Fortune. So you do feel as though you were lucky to meet this person. Jupiterian energy, it's Sagittarius energy. It is destiny brought the two of you together. How does your person see you? They're looking at you defensively. Why? The Four of Cups. Ah, so there's a chaos and conflict right there. It looks as though you question their interest in you because the Four of Cups is the Four of Cups, and this is how you view them. And so they feel defensive because it looks like you asked them how they felt about you. Okay, you asked them to share their feelings, and that made you, you asked them to share your feelings, and they're kind of like, what? They may think that it's not time yet to do that. So the Death card is here, the Nine of Cups. You're like ready to leave the party. If the party's over, you're out of here. Okay? We have the Fool card for them. Let's clarify that Fool card. The Eight of Swords. Okay, they're not going anywhere. They're not doing anything. They're just really looking and seeing what you're doing. Self-imposed restriction. Again, they feel like they've been backed up against the wall, rightfully or not so much, whatever. So you have the Ten of Coins here. Let's clarify that Ten of Coins. The Empress card, you want to be the Empress. Makes perfect sense, right? You want to attract a beautiful, abundant life. That's what the Empress does. The Empress does have a Ten of Coins type of marriage. And let's see why we have the Two of Cups here. The High Priestess. Oh, your person's being very secretive. They're not telling you that they see you as a potential mate. They're not telling you that. Okay, they're just not. So they love you or they're having feelings. They're up in their feels, actually, somewhat more than you are. But they're not speaking at Cancerian energy, Taurus energy, Gemini energy, Pisces energy,
Cancer energy and Sag. Okay. So we have the Four of Cups here. So why is the Four of Cups here? The Two of Coins. So you view them as a person who may be juggling you. They view you as the Knight of Cups. And why? The King of Wands. So you've been very fiery, very passionate. You've been very outgoing with them. You've kind of just, you know, here I am. I'm ready for romance is what you're saying. And they are, you know, so they really think that that's where you're at. You're in a more romantic space than they are, but secretly they're hiding their feelings here and they're feeling butthurt over here because you asked them about them. All right, so the Ace of Coins is an offer you would like, and why is it here? The Queen of Swords. So you will cut anybody out who doesn't want to be on the same page with you. Again, that same energy that they have, right? They have the energy here, essentially. Okay, why is the Justice card here for them in terms of their feelings? They are wanting to tell you that you need to calm down, you need to be fair, you need to be more thoughtful or more... You need to weigh and balance things out more. They do think that you're being a little impetuous. And so what I'm seeing here is a different kind of communication style. I'm seeing the two of you, you know, having a lot of similar feelings, but being kind of, you're both very determined to get what you want, which is good. I think there's clarity here. Why is the Star card here for you, Capricorn? Seven of Swords. You feel that it's really great that this person is a rock star and that they don't lie. Let's see why else is the Seven of Swords here. Let's see what that's about. It looks as though the two... Oh, okay. Remember, we have chaos and conflict here, right? So that was the first card out of the deck, and both of you are being asked to be very flexible because this is a worthy relationship. So what we're getting here is that the Two of Cups, it looks like this person may have told you during lovemaking or sometime when you were close to each other, they might have whispered that they loved you. And so now when you look at them sort of just looking at the starry nights and everything, this, you know that they love you. You know the Two of Cups. The Two of Cups is hidden here, and that's, and you see them being silent, and you feel that they should tell you that. That's the source of conflict. You have asked for their emotions. You know they have them. They have really shared a lot of positive energy with you, and they're hiding them. And so while they're thinking they're being discreet, you're thinking, well, you know what? You could be, you know, you need to tell me the truth. And so the chaos and conflict here is, again, a different communication style is leading you into this feeling that the two of you, you know, that there's an untruth being told. Now, you think that they do not, okay, Capricorn? Let's see what else we have here. Why do we have a Capricorn Queen here for how they view moving forward with you? Three of all Lovers card. They feel as though they're making the choice to move forward in this relationship. Now, that's how they view the way that it will move forward, is that they have to make that choice. The Hermit card looks like you've ghosted them. Yeah, you're kind of in this energy. I feel as though you're giving them some, I wouldn't call it shade exactly, but the World card is that you may well be finished with this. And that's what they're, you know, that's a message that's hidden. The underlying tension is what I'm seeing. They want a victory with you. They see you as a Queen of Wands. So King of Wands, Queen of Wands. So there's some definite passion here. There's really a definite attraction. You want the same things. The communication needs to be better. Okay, so we have Temperance card for how you feel. You want to balance things out. You want them to work. The Nine of Pentacles says that, you know, You want the relationship, but you're not willing to give up your independence or being successful. You're not willing to bend over backwards for a relationship that you just don't know about. So now we have the Queen of Swords for them with the Emperor card, their way or the highway. So this person's really coming in here. They see you with devil energy. You see them as my way or the highway. And what we're getting here is the Eight of Swords, the Eight of Cups, and the Four of Swords is that your person feels as though, as we close out this week, that they feel pretty stung. They feel as though you've passed judgment on them and thrown them, you know, you've tossed them aside. The Fool card, yeah, see? So they feel as though you're not in it to win it, that you've tossed them aside. So it's kind of a weird, it's kind of a weird reading in some ways. It's just like a total misunderstanding. So what do we have here for advice from Destiny, the Sacred Destiny Oracle deck? Let's see what we have. Focus, okay. Focusing on getting over the conflict. Focus on flexibility twice. That's crazy. I can't make that up, right? Flexibility, oh my gosh. So Capricorn, you're really being called here. You are being called to be more flexible. New beginnings, a new beginning. Okay, so the Death card is, you know, faced off with this new beginning. What I'm seeing here, Capricorn, is you may be making judgments way too quickly. And just because a person doesn't, I'm going to switch this over. Just because a person doesn't communicate the way you do doesn't mean that they're not interested in you. I do feel as though both of you were at a different place in your singlehood when you came together in this relationship, and I feel as though your person still has old wounds to take care of. So let's see what the Heart of the Fairy Oracle says about your person before we close this out for you, Capricorn. What kind of energy does this person really possess? Are they worth the fight? Are they worth the wait? Are they worth a do-over? Because it does show that you are likely to work through this conflict, okay? Oops, there it goes. Okay, the challenge. Well, the challenge is the need for focusing on a new beginning. So that's pretty clear. What else do we have here for Heart of the Fairy Oracle? Prick up your ears. So better listening, more flexibility, not jumping to conclusions, okay? Don't just jump to conclusions because you communicate differently. The Rocks. Okay, now this just changed the reading, the last card. Okay, so the Rocks is a card about a king gone bad. So whoever is this energy indicates that this person, and you know, this person could be you, could be the other person, but the Rocks is a king gone bad, and it's a king that just is very selfish, very narcissistic. It's energy that basically says my way or the highway, but even then, the level of willingness to be true to one partner is limited. Now, what's interesting about this is that you're both feeling this about the other. And so, because I have devil energy for how your person, you know, thinks that you're behaving, and you're feeling as though you need to pass judgment and cut the cord. So it's very interesting energy. I'm going to leave it there. Please leave comments down below. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.